Thank you, Matt. Back to that U.S. Marshal-involved shooting. Mm-hmm. We're told tonight that that man is in critical condition.
Meanwhile, investigators remain on the scene. It's near Forest Home and Lincoln. That's where WISN 12 News' Mike Anderson begins our live breaking news coverage.
Jason, we do have an active crime scene in progress here at the intersection of Lincoln and Forest Home, and it's been going for 2.5 hours now. It happened around 2:30 this afternoon. Robert Hodson works for Diamond Motors right in front of it.
Come out to take a look, and, you know, unmarked squads, everything going down. Car stops right there. Guy gets out. Cops shoot him 5 times. Didn't even give him the commands or anything.
D'Angelo Rack was standing on the corner waiting for a bus.
And you seen the Marshall's car, like, put him over, and I guess he hopped out. When he hopped out, he either dropped a pistol or they seen a pistol and they opened up fire, shot him. It was like 6 gunshots.
Here's the official word from investigators. A male Hispanic was shot. He is wanted on a federal fugitive warrant. There was a vehicle pursuit, then foot pursuit. Shots were fired and a gun was recovered at the scene.
The subject revealed a weapon. Our officers engaged in fire with that subject. He was struck. He is in critical condition. He's been taken to a local hospital. He is not deceased.
Not deceased and in critical condition at the moment. We also understand that he was on the FBI's or the U.S. Marshals' most wanted list. And joining me now is my colleague, Christina Palladino. You spoke with the suspect's father a few minutes ago.
That's right, Mike. I spoke with the suspect's father, Juan Cuevas, who said he just left the scene a few minutes ago to go to the hospital to check on his son, Mario Lopez, who he says is in critical condition. He rushed to the scene here a little over an hour ago, clearly distraught and emotional. He had no idea what had happened to his son. He said Milwaukee police would not tell him anything. He said that his son had just gotten out of federal prison and was trying to turn his life around and was shocked to find out that his son possibly had a gun in the car. He says all he wanted to know was how his 27-year-old son was doing.
Yes, he was a convicted felon. He just got out. He's trying to get...
If he had a weapon...
He would not have a weapon. That's why I said he would not have a weapon on him. For that reason, I know he would not have a weapon because he's got a woman that's pregnant right now. They're about to have a baby. My first grandson with him. And they're about to have that baby. He's been trying to change his life. He's been trying to get back on track with society. They're not giving him a chance in this state.
Now, apparently the shooting victim was in the car with his pregnant girlfriend and 2-year-old stepdaughter. We are told that they are doing okay at this time. Back to you, Toya and Jason.